The first thing you need to do before connecting power to your Clasp system is make sure you have the voltage selected properly. If you live in an area where the voltage is 230 volts or 240 volts, you have to make sure the Clasp is set to that voltage before you connect the power. Not setting the voltage correctly will damage the Clasp system and it will void your warranty. So if you need to switch your voltage, it's very simple. Just take a small flat blade screwdriver, insert right here, and remove the fuse tray. This will pop out and will expose the voltage selector module. The voltage selector module is a small plastic and metal piece that can be popped out with a small screwdriver, and it's very simple to change the voltage just by removing that voltage selector, flipping it around so that the voltage you need is facing out through this small window area. Reinsert the tab, set the fuse that you need for the proper voltage, reinsert the fuse tray, and you're ready to go. Now let's talk about the back of the Clasp and all the connections here. You'll notice on the back of the Clasp many DB25 connectors. These are all wired to the Tascam balanced audio specification. The first set of connections here we want to talk about are the inputs. The inputs receive signals from your mic pre's or your bus outs on your console. This is the signal that is actually getting recorded to tape going into the Clasp. The next set of DB25s are the tape send connections. Signals from the input are passively sent to tape send, and these signals go out of the Clasp, tape send, to the inputs of your tape machine. Next, we have the monitor outputs of the Clasp. This is line level monitor outputs, and these go to the inputs of your analog recording console. This could be a small sidecar mixer for monitoring. It could be a large format console such as an SSL or API or Neve. Just make sure this goes to your line inputs on your console, and this is what you're going to actually listen to while you're recording. The next set of connections are the DAW returns. This is actually going to be the outputs of Pro Tools coming from your D to A converters going into the Clasp. The next connection is the tape control connector. This is a proprietary connection. It is not a serial connection. It is powered and it's proprietary to the Clasp and the Clasp remote cables. This is where you connect your tape machine control cable that came with the Clasp system to the Clasp hardware. Next, we have the MIDI in and out ports on the Clasp. These are connected to the MIDI interface that came with your Clasp system. Make sure that you have the connections set correctly. Make sure that the Clasp MIDI in is connected to the output of your MIDI interface, and make sure the Clasp's MIDI out is connected to the input of your Clasp supplied MIDI interface. If you get these backwards, the Clasp won't function correctly. So make sure you get these right. Next, we have the sync in and sync output. This is used to synchronize the Clasp with your tape machine. Unlike SMPTE, this is a temporary connection that is only needed when you first initialize Clasp with your tape machine. Make sure that the sync output is connected to an input in your tape machine, and make sure that the output of that tape machine channel that you chose is connected to the Clasp sync input. Once you've synchronized, this can be disconnected and is no longer needed.